I'm Ratnam Bhushan. Welcome to ASGIS Current Affairs. ASGIS Current Affairs. Join the best foundation course. The editorial of Times of India today, Saturday, September 28, 2009. Double the growth rate. Here are six double practical and quick ways to get 10% of GDP growth. This article was written by Mr. Chetan Bhagat. A 10% GDP growth is the right benchmark by the current government, which is stable, not dependent on the coalition, and it's a second term after all. If the more left leaning UPA with all its coalitions comprises in their scams could reach 8% GDP, it is the reasonable to expect India to grow at 10% in the current regime. Now in the sixth year, however, we are currently only at the around 5% growth. The reason for this have been discussed there in the numerous articles. It's a time now to focus on how to get 10% growth. The recent big cuts in the corporate taxes are a sure sign that the government now acknowledges that this issue and cares about growth. There are longer term measures such as investing heavily in the infrastructure, which will ultimately deliver GDP growth. However, the focus of the article is relatively quicker, doable measures that can rapidly enhance our growth. Some of these measures do involving giving up control, which are the politicians and bureaucrats don't like. However, no major country has grown at 10% without ceding some control to the private sector. When you fly a kite, the trade helps you control it. However, if you want the kite to soar higher, sometimes you have to let the trade to go loose. India's 2019 GDP is expected to be roughly $3 trillion, rounded for simplification. Since we are already 5%, the additional 5% to reach 10% growth requires another $150 billion of economic activity per year. This amounts to around 3,000 crore of extra economic activity per day over the entire country. Again, this is achievable. Here are six doable, practical and quick ways we can get that 10% growth. Real estate drives a large amount of economic activity and consumer sentiment for perhaps the first time in decades. So real estate prices are stuck to for the last 5 years. It can be fixed by a massive stamp duty cuts. States will have to be reimbursed, and the government itself selling fractions of its massive prime land holdings in the generate revenue. Agriculture, it is difficult to drive growth in India without the growing agriculture. Most of the fixes here are long term, just centering around infrastructure. However, one quick fix exists: legalizing medical marijuana. Already a multi-billion-dollar infrastructure worldwide. Cannabis is already part of India's culture. As India an agricultural country, we are missing out of a worldwide boom. 20 years later, in line with the world, we will probably legalize it anywhere. Why not now? Of course, as with any drug like this, a careful regulatory policy has to be thought through. And divestment, the government keeps talking divestment, but even unable to meet targets as a selling individuals, it takes a lot of time. A better way might be consolidate, say, 20 PSUs into a fund of holding company called a divest company, and sell the divest company shares in significant discount of attractive investor. Thereby, we sell all the companies at once, and it's a massive headache. Customs, there is something wrong with the way Indian customs duty works. It is not such with itself in the delays, import, export, defense at our airports and seaports that make the entire nation uncompetitive. If we want to grow at the turbocharge pace, this bottleneck has to fix a simple uniform customs duty, maybe giving up the current inspections procedure. More work is required, but this is definitely choking our growth. Financial reform, the lowering of the corporate taxes rates, was a welcome move. Some more steps are still required. Long-term capital gains tax should be removed. The rupee must move towards a full convertibility. Another huge move the government could consider is not taxing global income for residential, at least for the next 10 years. The revenue loss from this will be limited, as one gets credit from the foreign tax paid anyway. However, it will attract much needed global investor and firms who are sitting on the sidelines right now to incorporate themselves in India. Investor protection bill, we have to realize Investor invest best on the projects and image spectacle spade seats of the financial modes of fill the assumptions on tax rates and other costs are glowing and attend when the government changes rates. Suddenly the global the model goes awry. Investors that the certainty we need or licensely ensured no sudden ad hoc and frequent policy changes in the taxations and regulation that might be adverse to Indian business. The India ideas have relatively quick fixes to boost our GDP growth. Ultimately, we need a longer term measure to create a solid foundation for a growing economy. Infrastructure is the single biggest thing in government can do. Better roads, ports, airports, cell phone networks, power and water availability. Indian infrastructure used to all third world levels. Things have improved somewhat in last two decades, but we still have a long way to go. Ultimately, economic growth will be a big criterion when the history will judge its India's current era. However, disappropriate negative talk, excessive politicized sages from GDP growth and the defeatist attitude will get us nowhere. Neither will too much control. Instead of the headlines like highest tax collections ever, we have to now inspire the headlines like the highest GDP growth ever. It's a party to think strategically and do what it takes for 10% GDP growth, and it will happen. This is India's time. Let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. Thank you so much.